Hey Siri, turn the Nest thermostat in the kitchen to 20 degrees. Now you've just witnessed something I've been trying to do for nearly a decade, and that is control Nest products made by Google from Siri and the voice assistant that's built in as part of Apple HomeKit. Now, the seemingly impossible is now possible thanks to this little box I got here, the Starling Hub. It has one purpose in life, and that's to get those two systems to talk together. So I was very much an early adopter of the Nest smart home technology. I bought the smoke alarm.
Ready in the kitchen.
The thermostat, the camera, and then even the outdoor camera when that came along. But then kind of got disillusioned really, because this utopian world where everything sort of talks together and we have this smart home was blocked because Google wouldn't talk to Apple, Apple wouldn't talk to Alexa and Amazon and Ring and all these other things that came along. So I kind of paused my smart home adventure until this Starling device came along. And what I've discovered, the Starling device actually makes Google products better because it allows us access to the sensors that are packed into the products themselves. So, for instance, we can find out if anybody is in this kitchen by asking Siri. Hey Siri, is there anybody in the kitchen?
Where's the sausages?
It's great that you can now bring in the Nest camera footage within HomeKit, but there is one slight downside with the older generation cameras. You can't get access to stored footage and keep that in iCloud. You will need a newer generation of the Google Home branded cameras to do that. If you want to access footage that's stored from existing Nest cameras, you will still need to use a Nest Aware account. Oh, who said that? With access to a huge range of sensors and trigger functions, we can now start to bring smart home technology together to create great applications that bring convenience to the homeowner, but also great energy saving features as well. So we're going to create a quick automation within HomeKit. Dead easy, just look for add automation. And the automation we're looking for when a sensor detects something. So we go in there and we've got loads of options there. So we're looking for in the kitchen, the protect occupancy, which is built into the smoke alarm, next. And then when do we want it to happen? So you can set time based, so you could have this just to happen when it's dark. You could even have it for certain people. So certain people are deprived of light and some people get it. But we're going to give everybody and any time of the day. And then we're just looking for what happens when our automation is triggered and we want the kitchen lights to switch on. And there we go, job done. So now we've built our automation, it's time to test it. I'm gonna vanish out of the room. Hopefully the lights will switch off. And then in a few minutes, I'll come back in. Ah, success, we have light. You will notice there is a slight delay there now because we're assuming some of that communication is still happening in the cloud. So it does take a few seconds for the various systems to communicate with each other. So that might not be ideal for all applications. But one thing you could do as a workaround, you could still obviously use a traditional switch or dimmer plate to set the lights on and then use that function to switch the lights off when nobody's detected in the room. So a great energy saving feature. We could also use the occupancy sensor in the smoke alarm to turn down a radiator valve when nobody's in the room, so enabling savings in our heating system. The Starling Hub hardware is pretty simple to install. It does require a hardwired Ethernet connection, so I've plugged it into a spare way on that switch there, or you could plug it directly into your internet router. It does need a USB power supply, which brings up one small issue. So the Starling Hub ships from the US, which is great. Apart from the plug that comes with it, this is completely useless for anyone who lives in the UK or Europe, so there's no point sending it. We don't want more e-waste than we already have, but until then, we have to find uses for this before it goes in the bin. I think it's quite good at useful for picking up sausages. So Starling don't really need to ship a power supply at all because most people who have Nest products end up with loads of these small USB power supply adapters. It would also be good to see a USB-C port at this end as well, because that's the direction of travel that we're going in with all these appliances, and it's almost becoming law in Europe anyway. In terms of the setup, there's a Starling app to install on your smartphone. Once you've got that installed, it's a case of linking your existing Nest or Google account. and then setting this device up as its own device within HomeKit by scanning the QR code on the back. You do get a little warning there to say it's not an authorized Apple accessories, because we think these companies still don't really want to talk to each other, at which case you're probably thinking, well, is this device going to be redundant when Matter comes along? And Matter is the standard that all the big guns have agreed on that will be the future of smart home automation. Now, I think this will still have a life for quite some time, because the devices we've got installed here are older generation devices, and it's not really clear how existing devices will be supported in the new Matter world. Will firmware be easily updated for those smoke alarms, and what we've got here are really early generation devices. I've been using the Starling integration for about the past month, but I haven't had time to do all of the integrations that I'd like to get everything all working as one harmonious smart home. I would like to get any questions or comments that you have about the system, if you're looking to buy it and adopt it, or you've already installed it. But in our next video, I think what I'm going to try and do is control this outdoor light using detection zones and triggers that are programmed into this Nest camera as an alternative to using a conventional PIR behind us. So that video, if we've already made it, will be floating around here somewhere. If not, make sure you subscribe to the channel and you can get notification when that drops.